To say Cyberpunk 2077 has been polarizing or divisive is a huge understatement. I don't think I've ever seen so many people on Twitter and social media in general agreeing and disagreeing about different aspects of a game. And in this video, I'm going to bring you everything that I think is wrong with Cyberpunk 2077 right now. But keep in mind, I've been taking a break from playing it on my PS5 because I've just been waiting for the big update that CDPR said they're going to release in January because I've just been experiencing way too many bugs. But I'm going to be going over everything that's wrong with the gameplay and with the world as of right now, in my opinion. Let's do it. Now let's start off with three things that overall break the immersion for me in Night City. Those things are the lack of interaction in this world, the stupid AI, and the stupid law enforcement. Let's start off with number one, the lack of interaction. Here's the thing, Night City is beautiful. I've said that in my first impressions video, which if you haven't seen, I'm going to leave a link in the description below. And I'm going to say it here again, I'm never going to take that away from CDPR. They definitely did an amazing job with making this world not only feel futuristic, but making it stylistic and making it just super beautiful. I mean, as soon as you get into this game, the first thing you want to do is go explore and go see everything. But what's the point in going to explore if there's nothing for you to interact with? Now, don't get me wrong, there are some areas in the world where it feels a little bit alive because you see a lot of NPCs and you can hear a lot of conversations going on. But what's the point if I can't take part in any of these conversations, if I can't participate in a conversation with an NPC? CDPR went the mile, they went the distance, man, with making every single NPC look unique and look special, but I can't talk to any of them. If you go up to a street vendor, if you go up to a weapons dealer, you can't talk to any of them, and it just feels like a really missed opportunity because it makes the world feel dead. When you're walking around this world and you're taking pictures and you're taking in all the buildings and all the beautiful things that there is to see, but you go up to NPCs and you can't talk to anybody, that just makes the world feel dead. The lack of interaction with the NPCs, the lack of interaction with the world overall. You go up to certain doors and they're always locked and there's no keys for them. It just feels like CDPR just went the mile and they went the distance, you know, with making the world feel beautiful, but they didn't actually take the time to make the world feel alive. And that's a huge problem because that just breaks the immersion. It's so crucial in open world game to be able to explore. And one of the biggest things in exploration in an open world game is being able to interact with the world. So how are you going to give us a beautiful world like Night City, but you're not going to let us interact with it? I really hope that going forward with all the updates that they're going to release that they can fix this, but I'm pretty sure it's going to take a long time. Another thing that doesn't help the overall world feeling lifeless is the AI. The AI in this game, in a word, is just stupid. I mean, I honestly don't know how else to describe it. Look at this clip here. I'm going up to different vehicles expecting a different reaction from each set of NPCs. Every single car had the same reaction. This is boring. I really wish the AI would just be more realistic. I'm not asking for something super complicated, but at least give us something with variety. Give us NPCs that react realistically to us when they see us, or maybe they want to start something with us, or maybe they're cool, maybe they're intimidated by us because we look so intimidating, you know, if you set up your V a certain way. Let them react, let them be more realistic. Overall, the AI is just really stupid, and this is another thing that I feel like is going to take a long time to fix. Now lastly, I want to talk about the law enforcement because that's also something that's just really immersion breaking for me. Now, I obviously was never expecting something similar to GTA where the law enforcement, you know, there's like a star system and everything. I didn't expect something as structured as that. But honestly, the cops in this game are just so overpowered and it's just so stupid. It doesn't make sense how they can just simply overpower you. There's no reason why I should be on a second story building shooting at people from below and then turning around and just having cops spawn on top of me or spawn on rooftops that are higher than me. There's no reason why that should be happening. I would at least expect to see a cool animation, like maybe a flying car that drops cops off on my rooftop. That'd be really cool to see. But the fact that the cops just spawn in, it just doesn't make sense. And honestly, as much as I know that this game isn't GTA, sometimes you just want to have fun and have some chaos, but it's not fun in this game because it can't be fun. The cops are way too strong, they're way overpowered, and I wish that they would just make the system a little bit more realistic in the sense that they would just make it make sense, you know what I mean? Just don't give us cops that just spawn out of nowhere and spawn on top of us. Just make it realistic, have them drive up to us, have them react. Again, this has to do with the AI as well, because the law enforcement system is, you know, it heavily depends on the AI as well. So honestly, we just have to wait, and hopefully in due time these updates will address these issues. Now, moving on from the world issues that I have with the game, I want to talk about gameplay really quickly. If you've seen my first impressions video, which again, I believe it linked in the description, I mentioned that in the gameplay, the biggest issues that I had then were the driving and the gunplay. The driving just felt really unpredictable and the gunplay felt way too wobbly, and it felt like most weapons just weren't controllable. And it didn't really have to do with the recoil, it was just the overall feel of weapons on various classes. You know, whether it's an assault rifle, an SMG, even, well, actually, to be honest, melee weapons do feel a lot better. Like katanas and staffs, but at least with ranged weapons, pistols, SMGs, rifles, and shotguns, they definitely feel like they're just way too wobbly. Those issues persist as of right now. The driving still feels unpredictable. I will say bikes feel a little bit cleaned up, especially after the hotfix 1.06 update. The bikes do feel like they drive a little bit better now, at least a little bit more weighted, but cars still feel really unpredictable, and overall gunplay with ranged weapons feels way too wobbly, and it's still a really annoying thing for me because it just affects the gameplay in such a negative way, especially when you're in a really high intensity moment, when there's just a lot going on in a room and you're trying to switch between your weapons, when you can't really feel like you can control your weapon, or when you're trying to drive away and you can't really feel like you can predict how to move your car, your vehicle. It just affects the gameplay and it just kills the vibe, in my opinion. Now, the last thing that I feel has really affected this game in a negative way, especially in the gameplay, is customization. CDPR was bragging from the start of their transparency with the development of this game that their customization system was going to be like top notch. It was going to be, I know they never said it was going to be like this revolutionary thing, but they did brag about it. And yeah, I mean, you can customize your dick if you want, but at the end of the day, that's not really that important, you know, especially when most of the game is in first person. You can't even see your character, which is something that also really bothers me. I have to be honest, the fact that most of this game is just in first person, that's stupid in my opinion. I don't care what anybody has to say about it. Give us options on how to play this game. Just because you want us to play it in first person doesn't mean we have to play it in first person. What's the point of having a really good character creator according to the developer if you can't even see your character half the time? And most of the cutscenes that I've seen, I haven't seen my V. And keep in mind, I'm almost done with the game. I only have one main mission left. So I just think that's also something that just, it's stupid in my opinion. But customization as well, like I mentioned, it needs work. You can't customize your vehicles, and the character creator as well is pretty lackluster because you can't even customize your height or your weight, and you also can't customize your weapon. So in the future, I would just love to see a lot more customization brought into the game. But that's all the issues I have with Cyberpunk 2077 right now. It's everything that I think is currently wrong with the gameplay and with the world as a whole. My name's Nico. Thank you so much to all of you for watching this video. You already know what to do. Thank you for watching, and I'll see all of you in the next one.